We don't know what Jesus actually looked like. The Bible doesn't give a detailed description, and the earliest images of Jesus that we have today come from around the 3rd century. The images of Jesus we have now also vary widely in how they depict Jesus, so they can't necessarily be taken to be accurate. But they are still of interest to check out. Earth actually brings you 6 earliest surviving images of Jesus. Enjoy. Number 1. Alexamenos Graph Fitto. The Graph Fitto was discovered in 1857 when a building called the Domus Alotina was unearthed within the Palatine Hill. The inscription is usually taken to be a mocking depiction of a Christian in the act of worship. At that time, pagans used to mock at Christians for worshipping a man who had been crucified. As you can see in the image is a head of a crucified donkey. I know for sure that this image would both have been considered as an insulting depiction by contemporary Roman society. The reason I think it would have been considered as an insult is because crucifixion was only used as an execution method for the worst criminals until its abolition by the Emperor Constantine in the 4th century. It seems to have been commonly believed at that time that Christians practiced onolatry, which simply means worshipping of donkeys or animals. That was based on the misconception that Jews worshipped a god in the form of a donkey. This was a claim made by Alpi and around 1st centuries, I mean before Christ's crucifixion. Number 2. The Good Shepherd. The image of the Good Shepherd is the most popular among all the symbolic representations of Christ found in early Christian art. This image was recorded by the catacombs in Rome before Christian imagery was made explicit. The image showing a young man carrying a lamb around his neck was directly borrowed from a much older pagan Creophoros. So, it is impossible to say whether the image was originally created with the intention of having a Christian significance or just for the pleasure of art and history. The image continued to be used after the legalization of Christianity around the year 313. Number 3. The Adoration of the Magi, or the Adoration of Kings, is the name traditionally given in the Nativity of Jesus, regarding the act of which the three wise men, represented as kings, especially in the West, having found Jesus following a star. It is related in the Bible in Matthew chapter 2, verses 11. In the earliest depictions, the Magi or the three wise men was shown wearing Persian dress and Phrygian caps. This is usually in profile, advancing in step with their gifts held out before them. These images adapt late antique poses for the barbarians, submitting to an emperor, and presenting golden wreaths. Number 4. Healing of the Paralytic. This painting was said to be found on a wall in one baptistry church. This was said to be in a long abandoned ancient city of Syria, and it depicts the story of the healing of the paralytic, as found in Mark chapter 2, and it is dated to the mid-3rd century. Healing of the paralytic at Capernaum was one of the most respected miracles of Jesus in the Gospels of Matthew, Mark and Luke. According to the Gospels, when Jesus entered Capernaum, the people gathered in such large numbers that there was no room left, not even outside the door, and he preached the word of God to them. The paralyzed man was brought before Jesus, accompanied by 4 other people. Since they could not get him closer to Jesus because of the crowd, they had to make an opening in the roof, just right above Jesus. The Bible said, from the hole they lowered the mat which the paralyzed man was lying on. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralyzed man, "Son, your sins are forgiven," and the man was immediately healed. Number 5. Christ between Peter and Paul. Christ with the book of the Gospels is seated between Peter and Paul. Below, the Lamb is standing in the center on a hill, from which flow out the 4 symbolic rivers of the Scripture. The historical and religious associations of the Catacomb of Saints Marcellinus and Peter are summed up, and are also illustrated in the beautiful picture, representing the Savior with Saint Paul on his right side, and Saint Peter on his left side. The heads of the 2 apostles are particularly fine, and the shape of their ears is their most characteristic in the image. Number 6. The image of Christ called Pantocrator. This was one of the first images of Christ developed in the early Christian church, and it has always remained a central icon of the Eastern Orthodox Church. This half selfie shows Christ holding in his left hand what is assumed to be the New Testament Bible, while he makes the gesture of teaching or blessing with his right hand. The oldest known surviving example of the icon of Christ Pantocrator was painted in encaustic on panel in the 6th or 7th century, and survived the period of destruction of images during the iconoclastic disputes that twice racked the Eastern Church, between the years 726 to 787 and 814 to 842. It was preserved in the St. Catherine's Monastery in the remote desert of the Sinai. This brings us to the end of the list. Thanks for watching. We will sincerely appreciate your comments to better or improve our production. Leave us a comment on what you think. Don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for being a part of this generation. One love keeps us together.